John, and thank you so much for joining us and doing in-person service here now. And also, thank you all for all those who are watching the Facebook live streaming. At the same time, we are so blessed to be connecting. So hope you start your new month in July with the Holy Spirit. Let me just share an announcement. Please open your bulletin if you are available. Not too many today. Right after service, you are invited to join the fellowship time with Dollars at Home. And also, blood pressure checking is also available in Dollars at Home. You can do it. And then, the bottom line, you see the special thank you note. Just the part of it, Dr. Young sent me the big thank you messages. A week ago, we did a wonderful job, right?
Yeah.
So, all hands on deck, and then we are so proud of the hosting. It's a great service a week ago. Could you read Dr. Young's special thank you message in the bulletin? And one sad news is that some of you already knew here. Our friend Birdwood went home with the Lord peacefully this past Friday evening around 7:30 p.m. Our deepest condolences and sympathy go with his family. I know that he will be cremated, and then the family and I, we are working on his memorial service at some time this summer. So more information to come. Please keep Birdwood in your prayer. A great firefighter finally get to sleep. So, yeah. And now I'd like to turn it over to the Mike Jones, the St. John's Pastor Step Parish Bridge Community Chairperson. Please, Mike, please come.
Thank you, Pastor. Yeah, I want to reiterate what a great time it was last week. That was a wonderful celebration of Kitty. This time, though, as part of our committee, we are proud today to announce that we have made a selection to replace Kitty. We give a lot of credit to the committee that did the interviewing, the scanning through, and then making the recommendations. I'm proud today to announce that Paul Zinza will be our new music director. Filling her shoes. I told him he doesn't have to fill his shoes. Fill her shoes. He's got to fill his own. He's going to make it his own. And we're going to be very, very happy and thankful for that. Thank you, Paul. We look forward to it. I have one other announcement, and that is that I've been notified that the district and the conference has yet again allowed us to retain Pastor J.W. as our pastor for the next year.
Church St. John's in the same year, 2018. The Paul was assistant to Oregon under Dr. Kinyan, and I just began my ministry at St. John's in the same year now. And Paul became a music director, and then we are so happy to renew our ministry together, a different style and type. I look forward. And you never know how much my family and I are so grateful to you all to do this ministry in this great church in the world. Thank you so much. Thank you. Worship today.
Thank you.
And we proclaim that God's faithfulness in our lives.
For God's steadfast love endures forever.
God has been faithful to our ancestors, and God is faithful to us.
For God's steadfast love endures forever.
But God has made a new covenant with us and through Jesus Christ.
For God's steadfast love endures forever.
Live into the joy of God's love in your life and worship God.
For God's steadfast love endures forever.
Amen. We join you for the affirmation of faith in hymn to page 881 of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, the born of the Virgin Mary, the suffered upon the cross of Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From the dead he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Jonah and the belly of a fish.
There's so many things. In Noah's Ark, and the woman at the well that Jesus teaches her about living water. So, the likewise, as we can see from the stories from the Bible, water is a gift to God, a gift of us through God's creation, and it is crucial to the survival of every living being, including us. So without water, we're going to be the very heart of the world. And that's the reason why that we must drink plenty of water and stay hydrated. If so, if don't you think of that, then we also need to give others the living water, which means Jesus Christ. So the when we give the cup of cold water to others, we also need to give the living water to Jesus Christ to others. I think that is the really great commission that we serve. So don't forget to bring your water bottle, right? When you drink the plain water, and also when you get a chance to meet your friends, your family, and your neighbors, don't forget, you are called not only the giving a cold cup of the cold water, but also the giving the living water to Jesus Christ by your good hands and the good ears and the good words and your faith and prayers. All right? Happy summer. Let's pray together. The living God, we call you the living water. The water is just so important to us to maintain our lives. To help us be the first person to give others a cup of cold water by our caring heart, and also help us to be the person who share the living water, that means Jesus Christ, with others. So thereby, this coming summer, be full of the living water of Jesus Christ. And to Christ we pray. Amen. All right. Enjoy the children worship time. Thank you.
home. We recognize that this offering is only one way that we call us to practice Christian discipleship. So combine financial resources with our talents,
prayers, and presence
so that we may significantly influence the lives of others to see your love. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. I join before the King of Illumination and the face we see, the black curtain one, the page 2173, Shine, Jesus, Shine. Truly, I tell you, none of these will lose that they'll be worked. That this is the word of God for us, the people of God. Shall we pray together? Almighty God, as we are celebrating the 4th of July this year, and we come past the new rule of the peoples of the earth. Inspire the minds of all women and men to whom you have committed at the responsibility of government and leadership in the nations of the world. Give to them the vision of the truth and justice, and that by their counsel of nations and peoples may work together. Give the people of our country the zeal for justice and strength of our forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will. Forgive our shortcomings as a nation, to purify our hearts to see and love the truth. That we pray all these things through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Once again, happy July. And to begin with, I'd like to express my thankful heart to you all for your support and prayers to make Dr. Young's retirement circus a great and wonderful a week ago. As you see the back side of the bulletin, the total number of attendance on that Sunday was how many? 153. Although the pandemic is going over gradually, the one big concern is that the people do not return to their churches these days. However, the resurgence made no trouble gathering together, sitting together, singing together, and eating together. And of course, it was a special opportunity to celebrate Dr. Young's retirement. But we also see a sign of a hope to move forward. That means that we centers is full of great potential to go back to our normalcy. In the John, the chapter 21, you know that there is a story of catching fish by the Jesus disciples. After Jesus' crucifixion and death, his disciples returned to their hometown Galilee and lived their lives by fishing. No more ministry, no more mission, no more miracles, just maintaining their lives by fishing day by day. When the risen Jesus Christ approached them, their fishing net was empty. Nothing was in their fishing net. So let me read John chapter 21, verses 5 and 6 again. Jesus said to them, "Children, you have no fish, have you?" They answered him, "No." He said to them, "Cast the net to the right side of the boat, and you will find some." So they cast again, and now they were not able to hold again because there were so many fish. After this scene, John, the chapter 21, tells us about how many fish they caught. The verse 11 said, "So Simon Peter went aboard and hauled the net ashore, full of large fish, 153 of them. And though there were so many, the net was not torn." But just like the disciples in the Bible, all churches had many, many nights without fish because of the pandemic. 3 years. But when the disciples followed the one Jesus directed, they could catch a fish again. This is the reason why we are encouraged here now. So the only thing we need to do is just to follow the direction from Jesus, and to regain energy, and re-throw out the fishing net. That's it. Now let me tell you about what I learned when I joined the reception after service a week ago. And my family and I were seated with the two families, Puja Kita Young, the children's parents group. I had a chance to chat with the Monian family in Fuji while we were waiting for our turn to be served. Jack and Luke, some of you might remember, they are very active children in St. John's Children Ministry. I asked Robin, their mother, whether Jack and Luke were baptized. And she told me that they both baptized. I love that after that. And they are originally from a Roman Catholic Church. She said, "Pastor, it was an accident for us to go to a Methodist church. What kind of accident?" The pastor answered, "When they adopted Luke, the Luke began to go to the CEC, our former preschool. There was a social worker in charge of their adoption process and gave them a special advice to find the place where Luke feels more comfortable. After sending him to our church preschool, they learned that our preschool belongs to St. John's UMC." Wow. So when they were finding a church for their kids, they thought St. John's would be the best place for Luke. And that is the reason why that they visited St. John's in July 2018. Surprisingly, that Sunday was the first Sunday for my family and me. So I am not sure how many of you can remember the first Sunday of July in 2018, 5 years ago. At least there were two families who were new to St. John's. One was the Park family, and the other was the Morning family. By the way, today, to celebrate my 6th year of appointment at St. John's, I'm so blessed to welcome 3 new visitors, actually a week ago. So if I would pronounce it correctly, Stella Ayangwe, would you raise your hand? Oh, thank you so much. Yeah. And then Mercy Tamer. Yeah. And Mary Edwina. Actually, the two of three attended the worship service a week ago. I'm just sorry not to the traveling here to serve the big Sunday a week ago. So, but you three are like a three magi. And one of the blessings to celebrate, you know what, the first African American music director in the history of St. John's, the poet Kiganja. And to celebrate my returning to church, and you three, a great blessing to all of us. I hope that we can continue on great fellowship at the service. Okay. So the, both the Park and the Morning family are the class of 2018, right? Yeah. But here's one more thing, why the Morning family decided to attend the St. John's. On the first week of July 2018, there was a power out. Any had something wrong on that first week. Robin refreshed my memory, saying that I gave them a phone call to check in just right after their first visit. The phone call was a game changer. They made sure that the St. John's is the church where they need to join because of their hospitality and sense of caring. This happened exactly this week, 5 years ago. As we know, there are many different things between Roman Catholic churches and and Protestant churches, such as church system, doctrines, liturgy, tradition, and so on. With that, I believe that the Morning family needed a lot of courage to attend the St. John's. Here's the point. Now, what made them choose St. John's? It was not Martin Luther, a reformer, or the Methodist Episcopacy, the system. It was their love. It was their love for their kids, especially for their just adopted son, Luke, to provide the perfect place where Luke feels more comfortable and friendly. And they began to join in St. John's. In other words, to provide a kind of cold war to their son. And they chose St. John's and have enjoyed their faith life here. In a similar way, and when the pastor tried to give the new family a kind of cold war to check in, this made the family respond to the pastor graciously. So, what churches really need is a sense of caring and through the love of Christ. Period. Yes, the maximum hospitality always makes a difference. Indeed, the showing hospitality had been regarded as a virtue in Jewish tradition. When they had a guest, they were asked to welcome and serve them as best as they could, from water to for guests to wash hands and feet, and another water to drink, even food to serve. And the Bible presents many, many stories about how they served the guests. With that, the Hebrews chapter 13, the first and second verses help us know the importance of hospitality. Let mutual affection continue. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without knowing it. For example, when Abraham welcomed three mysterious visitors sent by God so wonderfully, he was told that his wife, Sarai, will be pregnant. In relation to this, here's a great lesson in the text today, that Jesus showed us how to serve and welcome God directly. So Matthew chapter 10, verse 40 says, "Whoever welcomes you, welcomes me. And whoever welcomes me, welcomes the one who sent me." We all know that we all cannot be like Moses, who saw God face to face. And Exodus chapter 33, verse 11 says, "Thus the Lord used to speak to Moses face to face, as one speaks to a friend." We all cannot be like Moses. However, Jesus teaches us how to meet and serve God in our daily life. Giving a cup of cold water to someone makes us see the Lord from that person. In this way, we can share the living water, which is Jesus Christ, with others. And we also enjoy it. So now, as we are entering this hot and humid summer, hope you get more chances to serve a cup of cold water to others. This is the best way to fill your life with the living water. Enjoy a cold water this summer. Amen.
Amen.
All right, it's the first the Sunday of July, and I would like to invite you to join the Holy Communion. Please open your hymn book, page number 13. great Thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The lift of your hearts.
Lord.
Let's give a thanks to our Lord God.
It is
right and the good and joyful being always and everywhere to give thanks to you, O Father Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join the unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
The holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church and delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made us with us a new covenant by word and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. They gave thanks to you and broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup. They gave thanks to you, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, that poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of the sins. And do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of this, your mighty action in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
The power of your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine, that make them before us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may before the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood, and by your Spirit make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. And through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, our honor and glory is yours, the Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Let's sing the Lord's Prayer together.
Thank you.
because there is one love, that we who are many are one body. But we all partake of the one love. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. The cup of which we give thanks is a sharing in the blood of Christ. Eternal God, we give thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. I grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Once again, thank you so much for joining us today, and hope you have a blessed and safe and healthy, long weekend. Now it's time to sing the Courting Hymn. Would you please stand up if you are able? Will you join me for the hymn number 696, America the Beautiful? Jesus dwell richly within you till the time of your coming, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. against that.